We have to pass something. You know what? We don't have to pass anything if it's the wrong thing. And a lot of the parents, a lot of the teachers and students are saying that 1323 in its form is the wrong thing. One point I want to reiterate, which our good senator from JEFCO and, oh gosh, another county, I'm so sorry, but in L061, it limits the student's parents to excuse the student from taking the state assessment. In L059, it's all-inclusive. Districts are held harmless. It's L059 is by far the more accommodating to students, parents, teachers, districts. L061, it has its good points. You know, you cannot deny that. We're talking about the more inclusive, the all-inclusive, to which across the state, north, south, east, west, and everything in between, all of those parents, all of those students, all of those districts, all of those teachers agree. L059 is what they want. And this is why we're carrying it. And we have heard it's better to pass nothing than the wrong thing. L059 returns it to the language that actually those people wrote. Those people, the district who hold the parents, the teachers, the students, and everyone in between. I urge an aye vote for L059 because it is the biggest nonpartisan, most inclusive verbiage that they wrote. I urge an aye vote on L059.
They're over. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My good friend from Fort Collins is right. What she is pointing us back to is the best bill that we've seen this year. Senate Bill 257 is passed out of the Senate. That bill doesn't exist anymore because this is a bicameral process. We do not get to dictate the outcome. This is a bicameral process. And this amendment does give parents what they've been asking for. It's the closest that does that. We've already passed that out of this chamber, and the House dismantled that. Now we can do that again. We can make that same statement again. The definition of insanity, keep doing the same thing over and over again, expect a different result. We can do that. That is a principled thing for those of us who stood for Senate Bill 257. We can pass this through. We can make this bill 257 and send it over there to the House. And that's where it ends. If I could pick one, it would be Senate Bill 257. But I don't get to pick one. This is a bicameral process with a governor who puts his signature on that bill. The question that I'm asking you to answer for yourself is, do you want to reduce assessment? Do you want to create an opportunity for the districts to go out and build these pilots? Do you want to facilitate that to happen with a bill that could actually be signed into law? Or do you want to make a statement? We've already made a statement. We've done that. I ask for a no vote on the amendment. Senator Woods.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. You know, the parents in this state have come to this Capitol and rallied. They've called us, they've emailed us, they've shown up here, they have worked on drafting bills with us, they have begged us to let their voice be heard. We can vote for 257. That's what we're asking you to do. The parents have said to us, this morning I woke up to an inbox full of emails, hundreds saying, no more backroom deals at the Capitol. That's what they think we have been up to down here, is backroom deals. We send a good bill over there, they change it and send it back. They send a bill over here, and now here we are with two different amendments. The parents are frustrated with us because we're not standing up and representing them. I'm asking for a yes vote on this amendment. And if it doesn't pass the other house or it doesn't pass the basement, first floor, that's irrelevant to me. And it's irrelevant to the parents. They want to make a statement. They want their voices heard. They want federal minimums. They want opt-out. They want protection if they opt out. They want pencil and paper options. And if the governor isn't willing to give them that, then he will answer to them. I ask for your vote on this amendment.
Senator Merrifield.